So I'm going to present, when I submitted the proposal for this workshop, I was thinking of a recent project, which has recently started at my group at the Institute of Computational Research in the University of Zurich. But then it turned out that we haven't made so much progress so far. So I thought that looking at our presentations today, that I'll first give you a quick overview of things that we do in my group and another group I collaborate with. And then I'll talk specifically about this corpus for mental disorders. So the goal of the research, the way I'd like to present it, is that knowledge in life science is generated experimentally, data is being produced, submitted to databases, publications describe the work done by the researchers. Databases not only collect data, but they also read papers to find data, to find information to be inserted into the database. This process is to still to large extent manual. It's manual curation of the literature. And one aspect of my work is to try to help these people to find this information more efficiently. Another idea is to help the experimental researchers find information from databases, from the literature, again, in a more efficient way. So I'm showing two examples of this kind of work. Assisted curation. This is a collaboration with the RegulonDB database, which is based in Cuernavaca, a small pretty city south of Mexico City. Actually, I'm coming from Cuernavaca now, so just a few days ago I was there. And they have funding from the Mexico and from the NIH, big projects. So they invited me a couple of weeks ago because they wanted to insert some text mining into the curation pipeline. And we made a project proposal, which after some effort was finally approved by the NIH. Now we are working on a project, $1.6 million, to introduce text mining into literature curation pipeline that they have. The way we do it is basically doing automated annotation of the documents that they have to curate, marking the entities, and then introducing some techniques, simple filters that allow them to focus on those aspects of the text that they need to curate. I don't have the time to go into details, but the idea is simply that they will see less material than they would have to see otherwise if they were reading the entire paper as they used to do. This is something that they already published an experiment about, and they have good results. So we were showing that they can find in about 10% of reading about 10% of the material, 75% of the things that they were looking for. I did several similar experiments before with other databases, one with CTD as part of BioCreative, actually, and one with PharmaGKB in 2012. These are nice publications that show how this semi-assisted curation approach can help database curators. This was an example of assisted curation. Other things that I do is analysis of the literature with the purpose of helping experimental researchers. This is a project which was funded by Roche, and the idea was to mine the literature for protein-protein interactions. And what we did is a very simple approach. We basically annotated all papers for protein, then collect co-occurrences of proteins, and then do a global ranking of all these possible interactions. We have produced this interface where the users can basically select the protein, and then they will be presented with potential interactors. So if they agree, they get these possible interactors, and if they click on one of them, they get the evidence for that interaction. Abstract and sentences that mention the particular interaction. So these are examples of things that I do. My group has been very active in biomedical tech mining. We participated in several of the competitions, particularly BioCreative. We had very good results, best results, for example, in finding protein-protein interactions in 2009 and several others. I don't have the time to go into details. I also have some projects, not all of mine. Some of these projects I am PI, some of them are co-PI, and some of them it was just invited, like the Mantra project, which was actually run by Lipesh. Okay, so one of the reasons why we do so well in by the way, if you want to find information, just go to ontogene.org. So one of the reasons why we do so well in, or we did so well, is that we have a very simple approach for entity recognition. It's basically a dictionary-based approach. It's very similar to what Lars described in his presentation this morning. It's an approach that we've been using since 2009. Basically, we have, exactly the same kind of the structure, hash table. We use the same kind of window lookup to find things efficiently there. One of the things that I've been doing recently is to organize a competition as part of BioCreative. This was about trying to find components of biological networks. We're paid by companies to organize this. They give us the materials, the data, the funding, and basically we get this data. It looks like this. We get sentences and a schematic representation of the knowledge, or a structured representation of the knowledge expressed by the sentence. And what we try to do is to see if people with text mining capabilities were able to reconstruct the structured representation of the knowledge from the sentences that we provide. It's a very challenging task, but we're satisfied that at least five participants dare to try this thing. The complexity is enormous because you have a lot of namespaces, a lot of types, etc. So these are things that I'm doing. The things that I will do, this is a project just approved and will start next year, is a large-scale analysis of the literature to find information about melanoma. Funding just received, but project not started yet. So the thing I wanted really to talk about is this project, which is about causes of psychiatric, psychological diseases, mental diseases. This is another project recently funded, recently started, and the goal here is to annotate mental diseases and potential causes of mental diseases, and find techniques to detect them automatically. This is a big problem. Mental diseases are a major cause of cost, health costs in developed societies. There is a lot of information which is dispersed in the literature, and we would like to help people find this information. So, the way we are going to do about this. We want to develop an annotation scheme for diseases and causes of those diseases. We want to annotate a small corpus manually, and we want then to create a larger corpus using semi-automated techniques. So we had a look at the distribution of some of the disorders in PubMed using MeSH keywords. These are some of the numbers that you get doing meta research with these specific MeSH keywords. For the major disorders that we are looking at. And then we basically compiled a sample corpus of 150 abstracts, which has the same distribution. And what we are doing now is we'll start the annotation of this corpus. I thought it would be more advanced at this stage, but we are not so far yet. So basically, we are developing a small mini ontology of possible diseases that we are interested in, and potential causes of the diseases. This is actually a lot more challenging than this. For the diseases, we have resources. For the causes of the diseases, these are more widespread. It's not only, it can be genetic, it can be anatomic, it can be social. The causes can be many. So this development of this ontology is a bit more challenging. We have a small set of interactions that we will want to consider in this corpus. And we are going to use, and we are now using BRAC tool for the basic annotation of this corpus. And this is where we are now, doing some annotations of this corpus. And then I conclude with acknowledgments of people working here, in particular Philia, the person working in this project. And the reason why I'm here is that I would like to get some feedback from participants about similar work. If anyone is aware of text mining and corpus annotation relating to psychological, psychiatric diseases, then I'd be very interested in any if there are existing resources already that I'm not aware of. And what this is one aspect. And the other aspect is, of course, we want to make sure that when we complete this annotation process, the resource will be usable for the community. So we want to discuss standards with people, formats, etc.